Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Whole squad in the field, yeah, we tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
Tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. They count me out. It all begins
right now.
Catch me if you can.
Total catch up. But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoes. Drink it what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy he on fire.
Walk in that thing and air it up, been in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't build a little chick.
They say they truly love his paper.
You see that's some milk.
Why you catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shooting no bricks.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up. I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done build, it's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Now
count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling.
Don't
count me out.
It all begins
right now.
Catch me if you can.
Never really care what they say.
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Chain, chain, raquets, raquets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your play. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Ma, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Now
count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
If I don't do nothing, I serve. Really, I'm super absurd. Got them all dead like purge. Leave them speechless, no words. Leave them speechless, no. Coming in first, who's third? Tight fit, showing my. Lights, camera, action like verbs.
Going hard for my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer.
I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. Keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that.
Yeah,
eat him up.
I could do it better than he can. Really like that, no pretend. Had to get him back just to revenge. I might go to Paris for the weekend. I might go with him for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I've been speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense.
Go on my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer.
I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Yeah, what's up?
Eat them up, yeah.
Yeah, I was on a little diet.
Eat
them
up.
For the summer. Even if they
eat
don't like, we're going to give it to them.
Eat them up.
And when he has tried me, I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerged from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Denver Broncos. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. To speak of, call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Well, this defense for the Jaguars, terrific last week in the season opening victory.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. That's out to the flat for Gordon. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened. Week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them.
Taking it right down Broadway. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Cortland Sutton, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Broncos have taken the early lead. Extra point from McManus is good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence. He'll buy some time right. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Flushed out right. Looking downfield for Jones. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. How about a 39-yard pickup? They'll take it. On first down, Robinson. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Bradley Chubb there on the tackle. Well done. Diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Here's Robinson again on second down. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Back-to-back stops make it 3rd and 10. Lawrence. He'll fight his man, LaVisca Chenault. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Lawrence to Chenault for a Jaguar first. Throwing now, Lawrence on 1st down. He's going to drop this underneath for Robinson. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
On 2nd down now, it's Robinson. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Now Lawrence to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So 2 3rd down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a 3rd, and now they deal with 4th down. And Lambeau will put this one through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
So 1 play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now Gordon on 1st down. Room to run inside the 40. And down to the 27-yard line. Another 1st down there as this one goes for 25. Even from up here in the booth, the play-by-play guy could tell that there was some pretty good blocking on the right side of the line.
Well, you have good eyes, and it's almost like a ballet when it's executed that well. Everyone in the right spot, everyone in sync, everyone hitting the perfect notes. A little more percussion and a lot more bass, I would think, than you get your normal ballet. But at the same time, that was well executed.
Down to the 25. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. Well, this defense for the Jags, terrific last week in the season opening victory.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get 2 or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back 4 times in the win.
Well, this crowd does not like that call.
Understandable reaction from them. That's their team that the penalty is going against. But you and I both know they're going to take care of the quarterback.
So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Following the penalty, here's Gordon. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Miles Jack there to make the tackle. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Second and 8 coming up. They'll give it to Gordon out of the shotgun. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves him with a third down and 8.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the drives and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
Jacksonville's pass defense holds serve. Fourth down. The kick by McManus is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Just a lone field goal for him so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. From the shotgun, Lawrence. That's out wide here for Robinson. A gain of 4 on the play, and just like that, it's third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
McManus's point after is good, and the lead is now 17-3. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Throwing after the interception, Lawrence. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon, and they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run on first down. It's Gordon. 43 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
4 yards remain for second down. Play fake, Bridgewater. And he's got his tight end fan. Touchdown, Broncos. Noah Fant, 27 yards. And the Broncos are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. First play of the drive, a success. 19 yards. And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Following the interception, here's Bridgewater. A leap, and he's got it! He got it! And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. Locke going to hand it off here to Gordon. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Throwing on second and 8, Bridgewater. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
On third down. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. Touchdown, Broncos! Jerry Jeudy, 54 yards. And the Broncos are able to add on to their first half lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still on attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard. The pressure gets to Lawrence, and he'll go down. Von Miller doing what he does best with a sack. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Here's J.K. Scott now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Hamler now on the return. Great blocking, nearly sprung him there. 28-yard return, and it'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over first and 10. On first down, Gordon got some real estate inside the 30. And he's finally down at the 21-yard line.
64 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
They go back to Gordon here on first down, and he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out.
Touchdown! Melvin Gordon, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Broncos continue to pour it on. So after the disappointment in the opening week loss, Charles, this looks like really a completely different football team.
They sure do, and I think they realize we can't start 0-2, and they're determined to not let it happen by the looks of things here in early going.
McManus's point after is good, and that will extend this big lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. From the gun, it's Lawrence. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. They'll run on first down. It's Gordon. He's to the 10. And all the way down to the 5. It's a gain of 20. As we wind down near 20 seconds left in the quarter.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing?
And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Melvin Gordon in the final seconds of the first half. And the Broncos would extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point from McManus is good. And the rout is on here in this first half. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. Now it's Hyde on the return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Final play of the half, it's Lawrence, and he slings one that's incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach at our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Jaguars with work to do, they trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports. And this will not be returnable, it's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive, and they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half, so where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done, and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely, but you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. On third down, Lawrence flush to his right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Great vision there by Lawrence as he scrambles for a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Lawrence. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle, you know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over.
And the pressure gets to Lawrence and he'll go down. Bradley Chubb, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. To try again after the sack, Lawrence. Man open, here is Jones. A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. Here's Lawrence to throw. And now here's another interception. Picked off by Justin Simmons. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He gets so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
137 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Gordon. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attack.
They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Melvin Gordon, his 3rd touchdown of the season, all coming in this game. And the Broncos add on. Now McManus for the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the 3rd quarter. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38. On second down, it's Robinson. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Now Lawrence. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. The 20, 10, and he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
Oh, this is becoming tough to watch. I don't know that I've seen three pick sixes from the same quarterback in the same game.
And I know that many are going to scream at the coach about why did you let him stay out there to throw those. But truthfully, what are the odds that you're going to throw three pick sixes in a game? You want to leave them out there so they can work through some of the rough stuff.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
All comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. Yeah. It just kind of emerges out of me for some
it's
reason.
It's deep in there, right?
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. They'll throw here. Beathard. Caught out left side by Robinson. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second and nine, Beathard trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller, and the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
Yet another mistake after the interception there, and gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't, and also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys, but being down this big, you also take even more chance. Paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge. Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now a 20th carry, number 20 here for Melvin Gordon.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
The Broncos on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. Here it's third and three. On the counter, here's Williams. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. He needed three, he got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. To throw, Bridgewater. That's to his running back, complete. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a six-yard gain, and it all works out. On first down, Gordon. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 177 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They'll run on first down. It's Gordon. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. It's a loss of four on the first down play. Bridgewater here to throw. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Josh Allen just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Left side here, that's the tight end fan. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Denver, they did what they needed to do. They split their first two road games of the year. And they will head home next week to take on the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they will fall to 1-1. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Arizona Cardinals. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and hit is mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear my